Sacramento police helicopter hits power lines in the dark of night, and tonight an investigation is underway, and we're learning the one thing that may have saved the crew's life. Tonight, a story you will only see on KCRA 3.
KCRA 3's Mike DeSalle joins us with exclusive video. Mike, it sounds like there's one thing that potentially played a life-saving role here.
Yes, indeed. And yes, the Sacramento Police Department does confirm it is conducting an internal investigation to determine if all safety procedures and protocols were followed in this nighttime helicopter accident. But one thing is clear, and that is that that protective device, the same one that is on live copter 3, likely kept this incident from turning tragic. This is video of the Sacramento Police Department's Air One helicopter. The cracked cockpit windshield and the scratches, evidence of a wire strike incident that, in the words of a police spokeswoman, ended very fortunately.
Absolutely fortunate.
A week ago Friday, an Air One pilot and his observer were returning from a police call near Folsom Lake when the chopper hit a power line. The pilot immediately landed in a now dry part of the Folsom Lake bed near Rattlesnake Bar.
It was not an emergency landing. The helicopter was working appropriately as it should. However, they just, as a precaution, decided to land the helicopter.
The power line first struck the front of the helicopter, went right up the cockpit windshield, and then was severed by that protective device.
It just saved your life.
Live Copter 3 pilot Ed Georges, who knows the danger of wire strikes firsthand, said this little device worked exactly as intended. It severed the power line wire before it damaged the rotors. This device, known as a wire strike protection system, or essentially just a wire cutter, in his words, likely kept this incident from ending in tragedy.
If it doesn't get cut there, it's going to go up and get caught on the upper cowling or wrapped around the rotor mass, the pitch change links. Could be catastrophic.
Chopper could come down.
Absolutely.
So he was lucky.
Yes.
And back here live, aside from the role that this protective device played, you know, the same one that's on Live Copter 3, I ask pilot Ed Georges, is it possible this pilot never saw the power lines that he struck? And he told me that that is almost a certainty, given that at night, especially after sundown around 9 p.m. when this happened, it is almost impossible from the cockpit to see lights, power lines that aren't lit up. Kelly, Dalton.
Just incredible, Mike. I mean, I know you said that the police are doing an internal investigation. What about the FAA? What's next?
Well, the FAA isn't investigating this in any way, shape, or form. In fact, a spokesperson for the Federal Aviation Administration told me that unless a public use agency asks for an investigation after an incident like this, they are not investigating. And in this case, the Sacramento Police Department says they notified the FAA, but it does not appear that they ask for any type of federal investigation.
Glad he's okay. All right, Mike, live in Sacramento tonight. Thanks.